rules, you think in your head, yay, rules, I love them. Or do you think, boo, rules, I don't like them. Boo, Mike? Do you think boo? Yes. Do you think boo? Well, today we're talking about rules. Now, you want me to have that? All right, thank you. All right, so rules pretty much everywhere we go, every group, organization, thing we do has some kind of rules. So in school, we have some rules like what? Give me one. What's a rule?
Don't run in the hallway.
Don't run in the hallway. What else? What do you got?
No food fighting in the lunchroom.
No food fighting in the
lunchroom. Good. No talking in the hallway.
No talking in the hallway.
There's this after school one called My Discovery. If you talk in the hallway, even in whisper, they get at you like you killed someone.
Oh my gosh. We are going to get to the not killing part in a minute, yes.
Throwing tables or like smashing a desk or like
any of those. You have to raise your hand in class probably if you want to say so. Can't leave the building, Camille, right, without permission. Those are all rules in school. Now, there's also rules in sports. Like in baseball, how many people can be up to bat? One at a time. And when you hit the ball, do you run the third base or the first base?
Third base.
No, not third base. You run the first base. First base. You gotta run first, second, third, home. They gotta go in that order. That's the rules. If you got a homer, you do all the bases all at once. That's right. That's right. Okay, and when you're playing a certain card game or a board game, like for instance, this is Uno, you have to follow the rules.
You're supposed to look at other people's cards.
No, that is not one of the rules. That's a do not rule. So like if you get the draw two card, or you get the reverse card, or the wild, or the skip, you gotta follow those rules. Otherwise the game doesn't work right, does it? Do you know there's even rules for walking down the street? When you're walking down the street, you should stay on the sidewalk. Don't you think that's a good idea? Yeah, we're gonna stay on the sidewalk. When you get to the corner, when you get to the corner, if you saw this, what would you do? Well, you would stop, that's right. Okay, we're gonna try to say the right answers. Okay, and if we get to the corner and we see this, what do? Calissa? We walk, so those are all the rules. Well, a long, 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 long time ago, God looked around and said, things are not going so well. I think we're gonna need some rules. So he gave to Moses 10 rules. Not too many, 10. Things like, God should be the most important in your life. Don't cheat, don't lie. Don't wish very, very hard for something your neighbor has because you really, really want it. 10 rules. Honor your mother and father, Leslie says, an important one. Be kind to your mom and dad. 10 rules. So things went along. We started to kind of get the idea, but things were not going so well because sometimes those are hard rules to follow. So then God sent Jesus. And Jesus said, you know what? I'm going to make it even simpler. Two are the most important. Worship God with all your heart and all your soul, and be kind to your neighbor. Two things. Do you think those are hard?
Yeah.
Some days it's hard to make God center. And some days it's hard to be kind to that person next to you who is not doing what you like. So even two rules was kind of hard. But Jesus was sent here because God knew that sometimes we're going to fail. Sometimes we're not going to do everything right, but Jesus was our example, because when Jesus went around, he was always kind, always looking to help somebody. So he was our example. Yes?
How do you know if Jesus is actually existed?
How do I know?
Yeah.
How do I know? Well, I know because I can feel it in my heart. I can feel it. Yes, and I read about it in the Bible. That's how I know. Yes. It's a story. It's a story. We're getting deep here today. Deep. Save those questions for kids. connect. Leslie and Joyce don't want to talk about those and connect. Good thinking. I like the thinking because you know what? Pilgrim's a place about questions, is it not? It's a place about questions, so I like all of those. Yeah. So God, the best part about it all is that when we fail, Charlie, when we don't do everything right, God doesn't push us aside. God loves us no matter what, because we are God's children. We are God's family, and He loves us and cares about us, wants us to do good, but when we don't do good, God is still there. And that's a special gift, and you know what that gift is called? The gift is called grace. Grace. It's a wonderful, wonderful thing. And I don't know if you've noticed this in the back of the sanctuary, but we have our own pilgrim rules back there. We have rules for pilgrim. And it says dream big, which we were just talking about for the last month. Love your family, laugh together, have fun, share, listen to each other, say please and thank you, try new things, help others, always tell the truth, be kind, forgive and forget, do your best, give lots of hugs and kisses, and respect each other. Now, there are some that might be setting us up for failure there, but those are rules that we want to try. And guess what? God's still going to give us that gift of grace no matter what. Yes.
What if people worship other gods?
Yeah, they do. People do worship other gods.
And why do you say worship God, not other gods?
Yeah, I really got the brain cells going today. Yeah. Okay. That is a good question. A good question. Dear God, let us pray. You have given us the gift of grace. We will try our best to keep you centered in our lives and to care for our neighbor as we would for ourselves, to love them as we love ourselves. Help us to keep on asking questions, God, because our faith is ever evolving. It is a journey. Whether we are 6 years old like Charlie, or whether we are 66 years old, we keep on asking God and looking for the answers, and our faith keeps growing. Amen.